We've been pondering the mystery of why some cheeses smell like stinky gym socks. So we posed the question to our friends at St. James Cheese Company. Why do some cheeses smell bad, but according to their devotees, taste delicious? Most stinky cheeses are made in similar ways. They're washed rind cheeses. After the cheese curds are placed in their wheels to age, washed rind cheeses are bathed in salty brine, or sometimes booze. Epoisse, the king of stinky cheeses, is washed in strong brandy.
It is washed in a solution of brine and Marc de Bourgogne. It's a spirit that the winemakers will make there out of the grape must. It's like jet fuel if you drink the stuff. It's like really strong. But they wash it with a solution that includes a little bit of the Marc. And it produces this wonderful small, it's about an 8 or 10 ounce, this little stink bomb of gooiness.
The washing process introduces salt and flavors from the brine. It also brings in cheese's best friend, microbes, although they can also be added in the form of starter cultures. Washing creates a warm, moist, salty environment that certain microorganisms love. And the star of stink is a bacterium called Brevibacterium linens.
Typically what happens is a cheesemaker will wash the outside of a cheese with some kind of liquid. So it could be wine or beer or cider or just a salt water solution. And the moist, salty, wet on the rind basically attracts bacteria that's ambient in the air called Brevibacterium linens. The Brevibacterium linens colonate on the outside of the rind because they love that salty, wet. And they basically break down the protein that's on the rind and they emit gases, which does not sound appetizing. That sounds gross.
Incidentally, you know what else is warm, moist, and salty? Sweaty human skin. Close relatives of bee linens, like Bee epidermidis, have been found on human feet.
Which is the same type of bacteria that's like in dark places in humans, like feet and armpits and stuff like that. So that's kind of why, you know, people are like, why does my gym sock smell like a cheese? They're very closely related.
Microbes, mostly yeasts and molds, eat the fat and protein in the cheese and produce smelly compounds, including volatile fatty acids like propanoic acid and isovaleric acid. Perhaps not coincidentally, those same compounds are implicated in foot odor. Even worse, bee linens comes along and converts methionine, a sulfur-containing component of protein, to methane thiol, dimethyl disulfide, and dimethyl trisulfide. Funny how every time we mention sulfur in a video about smell, we're about to tell you something stinks. And yep, methane thiol is in foot odor too.
You know, it's probably not gonna walk off the plate on you. I mean, you probably have time to eat it before it moves.
It probably doesn't have fumes.
Yeah, you're not gonna offend it by telling it that it smells bad. I mean, it's gonna be okay.
So it's not your imagination. Stinky cheeses literally smell like feet. Bee linens isn't the only perpetrator. It gets along great with other microbes in cheese, like the yeast Geotrichum candidum. Some evidence suggests that bacteria and yeast work together to produce the distinctive pinkish-orange color of washed rind cheeses, which is created by pigments called carotenoids. And people learn to love these cheeses, despite or even because of their strong smell. Once it hits your tongue, the meaty, salty flavor isn't much like feet at all.
You kind of work up to it, and you win because if the cheese didn't ultimately taste good after you put the stinky thing in your mouth, you probably wouldn't go back for more. But I think that's what makes cheese so fun.
The smell of Epoisse is so strong, some say it's banned on public transit in Paris. Though the stories are probably apocryphal.
I looked on the internet and I couldn't find any confirmation of that.
When you smell it now, it's stinky, but it's a different kind of stinky.
Yeah.
It's a very...
It's perfumey.
Biological. Stinky, not a chemical stinky, yeah. Right?
It smells a little bit like hay to me. Like if you stick your head, I don't know if you're interested in smelling that, but like if you stick your face in a hay barn.
But I mean like right, I mean like right in the middle of that. I mean it's just, that's just this pure just stink for the sake of being stinky.
Yeah, it's good.
It does smell like a barn.
Either way, people learn to love their stinky cheeses.
At first with certain stinky cheeses, like you smell them and you're like, oh, why would anybody ever eat that? And then the more you're around it, you're like, okay, it's not so offensive. And then you like notice that you're excited about eating it and you like the funky taste and the funkier it is, the more you want it.
Thanks for watching. Tell us what stinky foods you love in the comments and maybe we'll make a video about them. And if you like this video, help us go on more cool field trips, meet cool people, and eat cool cheese by subscribing, hitting the bell to get notifications, and sharing this video with your friends. See you next week.